Now we will know what are the different types of digital data transmission. So digital data transmission. So already we know digital data transmission transmits the data in two formats. It is either 0 or 1. 1 or 0. Low voltage, high voltage. So data is transmitted in discrete form. In this form. 1 0 1 0 1 0. In this form data are transmitted. Now there are two types of data digital data transmission. One is parallel, other one is serial. One is serial digital data transmission, other one is parallel digital data transmission. So first we will discuss what is parallel data transmission. In parallel data transmission, suppose this is a sender. It wants to send data and this is a receiver. This is a receiver. It we have to transmit the data into the receiver. So in parallel data transmission, a number of parallel wires are used to transmit the digital data or bits from sender to receiver. If there are 4 bits need to be transmitted from sender to receiver, then there are 4 parallel wires are used. Each wire carry 1 bits. Each wire carries 1 bit of information. That means to transmit n bit of information, we need n parallel lines or n parallel wires. That's why it is called as parallel digital data transmission, since it carries bits. And so for n bits, there are n wires. So tell you know now, if 1 second is required to transmit 1 bit of information from sender to receiver, so to transmit 4 bits, how much time is required? 1 second. That means, since there are 4 wires, so each wire carry 1 bit, required 1 second, means 4 wires also needs 1 second to transmit 4 bit. That means, each wire carries 1 bit of information from sender to receiver in 1 second, means 4 bits also transferred in 1 second. So, what are the advantages? It is very faster data transmission. And here there is no chances of traffic, there is no chances of congestion is here. Here the disadvantage is that it is very costlier because number of wires are more. So number of wires means it is costlier. That's why in parallel data transmission the data transmission speed is very fast, but the cost of transmission is very high. This is the advantages and disadvantages of parallel data transmission. Now we will discuss about serial digital data transmission. In serial digital data transmission, data are transmitted bit by bit or character by character, one after another. Data are transmitted serially, bit by bit or one after another in a single wire. That means in serial data transmission, there is only one wire or one bus each used between the sender and receiver. The data are transmitted character by character or bit by bit from sender to receiver. So here the data are transmitted like this. 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0. In this way data are transmitted. We may combine the bits into character or one. For here 4 bits are transmitted serially, one after another. So in serial data transmission, only one wire is used between the sender and receiver. So tell me, if 1 bit is transmitted in 1 second in a serial data transmission, then 4 bits requires how much time? 4 seconds. Because each bit reads 1 second, and since there is only one wire is there, so that 4 bits can be transmitted in 4 second through a serial data transmission. So it is slower than parallel data transmission. So what is the comparison? Here n bit are transmitted through n channels. Here only one channels are used. One channel is used to transmit n bits. Here n bits can be transmitted in 1 second. Here n bit can be transmitted in n second. It is very faster due to use of multiple channels. It is slower as compared to parallel data transmission, as only one channel is used. It is costlier due to the use of number of wires. It is less expensive as there is only one wire used. So this is about your serial and parallel data transmission. Thank you.